time to catch up with things here at Brooks County with Maurice Freeman. So how does it feel? I mean, you took the championship trophy. Is there anybody here in the county that didn't get to see it?
Did you saw it? Did you see it?
I think
you were at the game. Yeah, you saw it. Yeah. Did you see it? Were you at the game?
Yeah.
Okay, I think everybody in Brooks County saw it. Yeah.
What did that mean to be able to do that this whole offseason?
You know, the first time we won it, I didn't think about the community. I missed out on that, and I regret that. So this time I said, you know what? These folks are so proud of us. I need to show them how proud of them I am. So I said, you know what? We're going to share this with them. So, you know, we had a Christmas program. I took the trophy. I said, hey, we'll be at the courthouse taking pictures with Santa Claus. And it just caught fire from there. And I said, you know what? Everywhere I go, I'm going to have it. Everybody says anything about it, we're going to take pictures. I want to show them how much I appreciate them. And that's what I did.
What other lessons from a championship season can you pull to bring forward to the 22 year?
You know, just because you suck at the beginning of the year doesn't mean you will suck at the end of the year. Just keep pounding. Just keep working. Work on your fundamentals. Work on teamwork, leadership, and stick-to-itness, and things will work out for you. Just don't quit.
Let's talk ours, reclassification and region. I know a lot of folks probably sat there and they had everything all organized. Then they had to organize it all over again, sometimes once, sometimes twice. Now that all the dust has settled for 2 years, what are some of your takeaways now with reclassification and your new region?
Non-region is the biggest thing. We got Wayne County, we got Thomasville, we got Bainbridge. We've had to play some pretty good size school. We had Buford to call for what, I don't know. Grayson called, hey man, you need a game? No, we don't need a game.
Buford and Grayson called?
Yeah, they called looking for a game. No man, you're single A. No, we're not interested. it was very tough. We went down to the last minute trying to find opponents. And that was tough. The realignment, we don't have as many teams in the region as we normally do. But we can deal with that. I just hate that it's every 2 years that we have to go through this. We really don't know where we'll be next year. We may be double A. Who knows? We just try to deal with it and just say, look, we're going to play where they put us, and we're going to have a ball, and we're going to play the best we can and let the chips fall where they may. But it's always a struggle. It's a puzzle. When you sit there and look at it, it's a daggone puzzle. You just don't really know where Brooks is going to fall.
I was going to ask, because when you're in teams that are more closer to being in those mini regions, MINI, mm-hmm. where you're having like 3 or 4 region games as opposed to 5 or 6, it turns into one of those big puzzle challenges that you have. That's a challenge for both coaches, players, and administrators.
That is correct. But it's very difficult for coaches, and it's very difficult for those sports gurus on Facebook that need to know and want to know everything. They can't get their little predictions right either. And if you don't have an inside scoop anywhere, it's trouble. So it's always a conversation piece, a huge conversation piece. And you just never know where you're going to fall.
You mentioned the appreciation that you were able to share in winning a championship trophy. Not a lot of folks know what football means to A, South Georgia, and B, to the BC on top of your head. For those that have never been down here and maybe saw you in the championship game, what does it mean to Quitman and to BC?
Well, for us, you know, every game we play goes back to the 3 kids we lost in that horrible accident. Every game goes to that. It's just our pride and trying to represent those 3 young men the way they've represented us. And from that point, it goes to, our pride goes to every player that's ever played at Brooks, ever played it. I played here. This is my place. I practice on this same old raggedy behind football field. And so it's just a lot of pride. And in this community, they know the kids. They come out. They get to come on the sideline after the game and talk to kids and take pictures with them. So it's a special bond. This is a traditional bond that we have that a lot of other systems don't have and a lot of systems in the north don't have. I've got a chance to coach daddies and sons. I'm coaching my grandson this year,
man. I saw
that. And that's big time. All those things are big time. How many coaches can say that? Certainly when you're in the north. That's very difficult. I don't know if you know anybody up there that can say that. But down south, this happens a lot, and we appreciate it.
That is the look at Brooks County with this guy who always brings something, a hammer, I believe.
Bring the hammer. You see that. You know it, man. We got it all. Hey, I'll tell you what. We bring the hammer. My tag on my truck says hammer, and my dog name is what?
Hammer.
That's right.
That's Brooks County in 2022.